Welcome back to Diavolo's Workshop, where it is a balmy 9 degrees. So, I really hope wherever you guys are, it's a lot warmer than that. The Northeast is just gotten pummeled over the weekend, and then today being Monday. Just crazy. We were supposed to have crazy snow here where I was. It ended up being crazy rain. Up north, I know they got a lot of snow. But today, crazy cold. I was out early this morning to go get the car inspected, and I was warming up the car a little bit before 7 a.m., and it was 5 degrees. 5 degrees. Horrible. I know it's colder up north a little bit, but yeah, we're not used to 5 degrees. So, this episode, I know it's been a little bit, but this episode is going to be a little bit of a bench update, a little bit of a stash update, and I'm really trying to get back on track to doing my weekly updates. It's been a little hectic around the Diablo's lair and the workshop. Had some stuff going on. Had to babysit the plumber one Saturday. We had some family commitments, that type of stuff. So I haven't been hitting the bench as much as I wanted to, so therefore I haven't had a lot of updates. So without updates, I'm probably not going to make videos. So where we are, the Jeep is pretty much done. Had to go back and redo the roll bars, and I think I mentioned that in the last video. That is a time-consuming process because it's actually a three-step process. I have to do the gloss black, let that dry, chrome it, let that dry, and then do the candy red, and then at some point I'll end up clearing it, which I didn't do before, and that was part of my issue. You definitely need to clear on there to protect the finish while you're putting it together. So lesson learned, that'll be done this time. The Nova, kind of having the decal rip up there and the clear with the, when I was taping off the window moldings, that was kind of a happy accident, I would imagine, because the new version is a lot cleaner and a lot nicer than the original. Don't get me wrong, the original was awesome. This one, I think I did a much better job, in my opinion. So, I don't know. So I'm a lot happier with it, which I guess that's all that counts, is as long as I'm happy with it. But, yeah, so that's where that is. I did get some other stuff done on the Nova, which in a second I'll spin the camera around and show you guys. And I also, we have a little bit of a stash update, and we'll get into that in a second. So guys, hold up a second. I'm going to spin the camera around and I'll show you what I got done on the Nova. All right, so there is the completed interior for the Nova. Definitely happy with the way that came out. And I'll spin it around so you guys can see it. Nothing major there, really. I mean, it's a race car, so I kept it real simple. Black, with a little bit of chrome accents for the door handles, that type of stuff. The only special thing I did, I kind of matched the roll bar to the stripes on the decals. And I kind of did that anodizing process with the roll bar as well. And I think that came out really good. I don't know how good you're going to see it through the windows and that type of stuff, but I know it's in there and it looks damn cool. I think you'll see it through the back window more so than anywhere else. So we'll see. I mean, it's definitely a cool little touch. yeah, so like I said, I kept the interior real simple. Came out real clean, real nice. So I'm happy with that. I'll move that out of the way. And then what I have, and I think I showed you guys this before, but the whole chassis is done. All the suspension components are in, motors in. And again, I did the gold anodized look on the oil pan. Heat stained the headers a bit. And I'll flip it over, and there is some engine detail there. I mean, I built it box stock, but I tried to make the engine as clean and detailed as possible without adding stuff to it. I think the engine came out really, really good. for a box stock engine. Let me see if I get that better for you. There you go. Everything on there was stripped. Anything that's chrome was stripped and re-chromed. The top of the air cleaners, those are chromed. The valve covers are chromed. The belt guard that comes off the alternator, that was re-chromed and then masked off, and I did the rest of the alternator different colors. Definitely happy with the way that came out. I think it's probably my best box stock engine build that I've done in a while, so I'm real happy with that. And I'll give you an idea what it looks like with the engine kind of centered in the with the firewall and the fenders. But like I said, I'm real happy with it. Looking forward to getting it done, though, that's for sure. All right, so I got that part done, and then I went and did the back wheels, and then the front wheels are nothing special. Back wheels have the Hoosier decal and the markings, the triangle markings on them. Those wheels were actually stripped of the kit chrome and re-chromed, and I think they came out really, really, really nice. Yeah, really looking forward to getting this thing together to see how it looks all together. Yeah, so that's where the Nova is. The Jeep's pretty much the same place you guys saw it last time. Hopefully next weekend we'll have an update on that. one other thing I wanted to show you guys. I'm going to put you guys on pause real quick so I can get it. But it's the Fuse Caddy. I'll be right back. All right. So what you see there is the Fuse Caddy body. Nothing real special there. It's just in primer. But what I did do, which I think made a huge difference in the overall appearance of the car, one, I took the peak out of the hood, so it's one nice smooth hood line, and I also shaved the crest off the front, again, to make it as clean as possible. Keeping with that, there was a spear that used to run over the top here of this fender, and the same on the other side. I actually took those off, again, to make it more smooth and sleek, and I also shaved the Eldorod emblems off this side as well, which was a little bit of a trick without touching the belt line molding. That's the only thing I actually kept on the car, molding-wise. I also went, and if you guys are familiar with the kit, there are two spears that run down the trunk line. Those are also have been shaved off, and the trunk has been shaped, and it's everything's nice and smooth and flush, and it looks really good. In my opinion, taking all those spears and moldings off makes the car look a lot longer and a lot leaner, lower to the ground even. Not that there's wheels and anything on it, it just makes it elongates it, and I think it's going to look really good all smoothed out like that once I get some paint on it. But yeah, that's where that is. It's it took a little bit to get it to that point. There was a lot of body work I needed to do, a lot of small seam lines, and some of the spears kept ghosting through, but I got that all sorted out now. So here is my question to the community, and I'm kind of not sure which way to go with it, but we'll see. So if you look at the engine bay, I was thinking of doing the inside of the fenders here, and possibly this front, or maybe just the radiator support, in like a gloss aluminum, and then have everything else body color, including the firewall, which isn't in there yet, but will be. What do you guys think? Or should the whole thing be body color? I'm kind of torn, not sure which way to go. I think that's the only reason why it's not painted yet. I have the paint, and actually the body is bodywork wise and primer wise, it's ready to go. I just got to wash it up again and throw the paint. But yeah, I was just wondering, what do you guys think? Should this here, the inside of the fenders, be a gloss aluminum, and possibly the radiator shroud be gloss aluminum and the rest of it body color? Or should I make everything body color, being that it's a custom? So definitely let me know what you guys think in your down in the comments below. I would greatly appreciate that. All right, so I'm going to cut the camera off, spin it around. We'll wrap this episode up.
All right, I'm back.
So you guys saw what I have done so far. Really hoping to wrap some of this stuff up sooner than later. They've been on the bench a long time, and to be honest, I'm kind of getting tired of them. And I have so many other projects I want to try to get done. But I did promise you guys a quick little stash update. And what I did pick up was the Porsche 944 Turbo Racing Edition from Hasegawa. This actually has engine detail, which most of the Japanese kits don't, but this one happens to. And the decals, I think, are pretty cool on this. I think I'm going to build it exactly like that with the pink and the Blaupunkt. And yeah, it should be something different. Not something you see on the tables or on, you know, out in the open every so often. So this is what I think one of these days I'll get around to this one. But definitely something I wanted to pick up while I was able to. And yeah, that's it. So hopefully next time we have an episode, which I'm hoping is next Sunday, I will have the Jeep more completed than not, or the Nova more than completed than not. I mean, the Nova, really all I need to do is do a polish on the body, which, to tell you the truth, the clear, I was looking at it a little while ago, doesn't need much work at all. I just have to cut it back a little bit. Nothing major, maybe like 8,000, 12,000, and then polish it out like I normally do, and figure out what I'm doing with the window moldings. I still think I want to do them black, and I still have to take care of the bumpers and the grill, which I'm thinking the bumpers are going to be gloss black on that, because I don't know if the chrome would look good against the silver car, but I have a week to figure that out, I guess. But other than that, I mean, everything is coming along good. Definitely looking forward to getting them wrapped up and getting on to new stuff. Hope everybody out there is safe, keeping warm, especially you guys up north. You guys down south, I don't really feel bad for you. I know it's like in the 60s down in Florida, and I'm happy for you, but not that happy. So anyway, yeah, so that's it. That's how, that's everything that's up to date, I guess. Hoping to get more done for next episode. We'll see how that works, you know, how life gets in the way. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. And remember, the devil is in the details. Have a good week.